Hello, welcome. So now we are on the part 9 of our design of a two-story residential building. So part 9 will be designing a reinforced concrete slab and including in stairs. Okay, using STUD RCDC. So let's open STUD RCDC. All right. Okay, input natin yung project title. Code will be 2015. Link natin yung STUD and then we'll go to slab. Okay, so sa slab, since second floor, dito na tayo sa second floor. Kasi wala na. Roofing naman tayo na. Sa roof beam. Second floor is 5.1 meter. Create new project. Nakikita natin dito ang yon. Okay. Tapos, as we so ito ngayon kasi, itong portion na to is an open area. So, wala tayong slab dyan. I-cut out natin yan. So, make it true. Ayan. So, open na siya. Alright. So, okay, initially, ang gagawin natin sa slab, i-input natin itong imposed, live, and thickness. Okay? So, thickness ng slab natin is 125. Okay, live load natin dyan is 1.9. Superimposed load is yung kinakarga ng slab. So, balik tayo dun sa loading, load generation, duty natin yung kinakarga ng slab. Not excluding the weight. And not including the weight. Okay. Yeah, suspended beam, suspended floor. Yung slab load natin dyan is 4.25. Okay. So, dito ko na lang ilagay. Compute natin yung weight ng slab. It's unit weight of concrete times 0.6 thickness ng slab. Yeah. So, yan yung area load or weight ng slab. So, deduct na lang natin. Yan yung magiging imposed. So, ang nangyayari, 4.25 less, yan. So, imposed load dun sa slab, meaning yung load ng floor finish, load ng ceiling, MEPF, et cetera, at yung mga dead load na yun, excluding yung weight, yung self-weight ng slab is 1.19 kPa. Kilonewton per square meter. So, 1.18. Yeah. Okay. So, naka-specify itong slab na to. One way, two way. Ito naman naka-ano na to. Naka-open na yan siya. Right? So, let's go to settings, design parameters. Okay, so I use natin curtailed. Hindi natin magamit. Well, huwag na lang may tayo mag-bent up bars. Rebar, okay, preferred diameter, 10mm lang tayo. What else? Okay, grade natin dyan is grade 40.76. Right? Yan. Then 3000 psi or 20 mpa covers 20 minimum thickness. You okay? Next, correct with setup one and continuous design time. Mm, Bam! Ayan na. Design na yung slab. Design na yung itsura niya. And then, dito tayo sa reports. Text schedule. Nakalagay din dyan. Meron ka pang schedule ng slab. Okay. So, along short and long spans. Nakalagay na dyan. Bottom top reinforcement. Dyan na. And implant detailing. Okay. Yan. Implant detailing. So again, pwede natin itong save sa CAD file, as a CAD file. Then, you know, gagamitin natin sa plan. Slab section, pwede ka rin maglagay. And then, next is yung stair. So, stair section. Now, yung stair naman, since dito yung portion ng stair natin, and then yung height niyan is around 3.2. Okay. So, okay. Bottom landing na beam. Okay. Dito tayo sa beam sizes muna. Bottom landing, 200 lang. By 300. Same here. Okay. And then, bottom landing, end of slab, correct. Number of risers. So, ang mangyayari, since that's 3.2, riser natin dyan ay 18. Okay, span. Span nito is, this is 5 meters. Okay, tama lang, 5. Height is 320. 3,200. Landing. Bottom landing. Top landing. Okay. Okay, draw stair. Yun na. Yun. So, ganun lang kadali yung sa stair. Then, naka-indicate na dyan, sizes ng rebars and spacings. Center to center spacing. Okay. Then, again, meron kang design calculations, POQ, and bar bending schedule if needed. Okay. So, that's the end of our series on designing two-story residential building using STAD Pro and STAD RCTC. Okay? Thank you. So, next series, I'll be making maybe series on, yun nga, yung STAD Foundation Advance. I'll be discussing, may i-design ko kasi next is a 4-story school building. So, that's sitting on a mat footing foundation. So, yun yung the next series ko about STAD Foundation Advance. So, foundation tayo next. Thank you.